Hi everybody, I'm Elena Moon Park. Thank you so much for joining me today. And thank you to the NSU Alvin Sherman Library for inviting me to be part of this series. I'm so proud and honored to be part of a series with so many amazing artists who I love and admire. So I hope that you're ready to do some singing and some dancing and some hand clapping, maybe some jump roping, maybe some hand motions today, because I would like to invite you to come with me on a journey around the world. One thing I really love about playing music is that songs and stories can really take us on a journey around the world to meet new people, to learn about new cultures, to learn new languages. And that's exactly what I want to do today. I want to invite you to come with me. We might sing in some different languages, we might learn some different kinds of dances. We might even be taken into some magical worlds created by the creative minds of visual art friends of mine. So that's exciting. So I'm here in my apartment in what we now call Brooklyn, New York. And I'm usually playing music in front of a red wall on my couch over there, but I wanted to start us off standing up in front of my bookcase in honor of libraries and books and reading around the world, because that's another way that you can take a journey all around the world is through books and through reading. So big ups to libraries and books. So let's start our journey today in Taiwan with a train song that I learned from a Taiwanese friend of mine. And I love train songs because you can find them all over the world. Everybody loves to sing about trains. What's not to love about trains? And this song is called Diu Diu Deng. One thing that I really love about this song is the way that the Taiwanese language sounds in the song. It's a very simple rhyme, but in Taiwanese, it sounds so cool. So I'm going to say it to you once in Taiwanese, the lyrics of the song, and then we'll say it in English and we'll see just how simple the song is. So in Taiwanese, here's how the song goes. It goes like this. Wei chan yama ito ama ito diu ayo bong kang lai. Bong kang etsu ito diu diu danga ito ama ito diu ai ito di lo lai. That's it. Pretty cool sounding, huh? So in English, all of that means this, and this is the entirety of the lyrics of this song. It goes like this. A train is chug-chugging into a tunnel where the water drips down, makes a sound like a dew-dew, sound like a coin when it flips up and drops to the floor. That's it. It's this very simple song. And the part I love about this song is the sound that the water makes when it hits the top of the train, and that sound is dew-dew. And we can all sing that together. Can we try it together? Diu diu! It's perfect. And as you can tell, I'm starting to do a little dance with my hands. If you want to move around a little bit, you can throw your arms up in the air when you hear the diu diu. So it can go, makes a sound like a diu diu. Got it? All right. The tricky part is catching where the diu diu comes in, but hopefully by the end of the song, we'll get those. And for the rest of the song, you know, you can do your favorite train dances, of which there are many, I'm sure. So let's kick it off at Diu Diu Deng. I'm going to invite some friends of mine to join us on the song. And the train will start chugging kind of slow at first, but then it'll speed up and get real fast. And we might just enter a magical world that was created in the mind of my friend Maiko Kikuchi, a puppeteer and an artist. So let's kick it off at Diu Diu Deng. Ready? Let's do it. All right. Get your arms ready for the doo-doo. Thank you. right. Thank you all. That was Diu Diu Deng, the Taiwanese train song. Thank you to Colin and John for joining me on that. Woo, that went fast. We're going to journey now to a different part of East Asia. We're going to go to Tibet. And we're going to sing one of my favorite kinds of songs again. This is a jump rope song. And like train songs, I love jump rope songs because you can find them all around the world. People sing jump rope songs everywhere, jump rope rhymes. And oftentimes the song is telling you what to do while you're jump roping. So does anybody here love jump roping? I love jump roping. I hope you have jump ropes with you, real or imagined, because it's a great way to dance to this song. And it's called Sisi Sima, which means gentle like a breeze. But there are two lines in the song that tell you what you can do while you're jump roping. So if you hear me say in the song, that whole line means that you turn in a circle to the right while you're jump roping. And then the next line is, and that line means you turn in a circle to the left while you're jump roping. And then after that comes a Tibetan rhyme, and it goes, zama zama sikit zama, tigo tigo nugi tigo. It goes on from there, but I love that part. I'll say it again for you once. Zama zama sikit zama, tigo tigo nugi tigo. That's great. Love it. And I learned these songs from some friends of mine. We went to Flushing Corona Meadows Park in Queens, New York, and we did some jump roping and sang this song together out there. So here they are, and we might see some more of them while we sing this song. So for the song, I'm gonna play this instrument. This is an instrument I've been playing since I was 5 years old. You probably know what it is. It is a violin. It has four strings and this stick with horsehair on it, which is called a bow. And you can pull the bow across the strings to make the sound like this. Just like that. So we're gonna do Sisi Sima with the violin. I'm gonna invite my friend Colin again to join me. And I'm gonna invite in my friend Domenica, a wonderful flute player and singer who plays in my band, to play the flute. First, if we think really hard, can we hear the sound? Yes, we can. Hear the sound of the jump rope hitting the ground. Do you hear that sound? All right, here we go. Sisi Simo Majalehuo Maje Gora Ye Koshigan Chame Gora Ye Koshigan Korai Koyla Gamna Ye Kutsiko Chaji Korai Koyla Gamna Ye Kutsiko Chaji Zama Zama Siki Zama Tiko Tiko Nugi Tiko Chirin Yala Kanchi Machin Yala Toshu Rasi Gyongyu Shenyan Tenso Tipa Rebe Yeto Chiju Chamu Sambe Wola Tse Chitanyamo, Sunday Wallet's we Sisi Sima, the Tibetan jump rope song. Thank you to Colin and Domenica for joining me on that. Okay, so next we're gonna go to Japan, the country of Japan. There it is. And we're gonna sing a song called Zui Zui Zukkorobashi. Can we say that together? Zui Zui Zukkorobashi. All right. And what does Zui Zui Zukkorobashi mean, you ask? You know, I've asked a lot of people that and nobody knows. It's kind of a nonsense song. It's a silly song, a lot of things happen in it, but no one's really sure what it's about. At one point, a mother's yelling something and a father's yelling something about breaking a rice bowl, and a mouse runs through the song and goes choo choo choo. But what's fun about the song is that it accompanies a game that kids will play with their hands. And we came up with a different kind of game for it that you can do with a partner. So if you have a sibling or a parent or somebody in the house that you can play a hand clapping game with, now would be a good time to partner up. So I'm going to teach you the hand clapping game. It goes along with the rhyme, Zui Zui Zukkorobashi. And all you have to do is face your partner, and you're going to clap, and you're going to slap hands like this. So it goes like this. Zui Zui, so you're slapping the opposite hand of the person. Zui Zui Zukkorobashi Goma Miso Zui. So clap, slap, clap, slap. Two claps, high ten. And the whole song's like that, except for one part. I'll teach you that. So it goes like this. Zui zui zukkorobashi goma miso zui. Chatsubone o warete toppinshan nuketara dondokusho. Tawaran no netsumi ga kome kutte chu. And in the song, when you hear the word chu, that's when we're going to change it up for a second and do three more high tens. Choo, 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 just like that. And then we go back to the pattern. Otsusan ga yondemo, okusan ga yondemo, iki iku no shia. Idon no mabari de ochoban kaita no dare. All right, did you get the pattern? So the song's gonna start off pretty slow and then it'll get faster and faster and faster, and then we have to see if we can keep up with the hand clapping. But to help us with the hand clapping, I want to invite another friend to join me and Colin and Domenica on this song, my friend Akiko Hiroshima, who also plays in my band and will help us out with the hand claps as we sing the song. All right, here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Thank you. That was Zui Zui Zukkorobashi. Thank you to Colin and Domenica and Akiko
for
joining
me
on that. Hope you kept up with your hand claps.
Hello, everyone. My name is Akiko Hiroshima, and I'm happy to introduce you the next song, Ito Maki. I grew up in Japan, and I remember singing this song and dancing to it when I was a kid. So Ito means thread, and maki means roll or wrap or spin, and hite means pull, and ton ton ton, it's the sound of tapping or hitting something lightly, like ton ton, ton ton, ton ton, ton ton, you know? So it goes like this. Ito maki maki ito maki maki hite hite ton ton ton. Can you try it? Ito maki maki ito maki maki hite hite ton ton ton. Very good. And the next part goes. Dekita dekita kuma-san no pantsu. So dekita means it's done, it's complete, we finished. And then you can announce whatever you made. So in this case, kuma-san no pantsu. Kuma-san's bear, kuma-san, and underwear. So pantsu is underwear. So, you know, I'm just pulling it up. Or you can make anything you want. So let's try the second part. Or maybe whole thing. Let's do this. Ito maki maki ito maki maki hite hite ton ton ton. Ito maki maki ito maki maki hite hite ton ton ton. Dekita dekita kuma-san no pantsu. Yay! So you can make anything of any size for any animals, any people, any characters, anything. So have fun with it. Enjoy. Hi, Mariana.
Hi, Roger.
Hi, Kika.
Want to sing a song with me? How about Ito Maki so we can make fun presents for our animal friends?
Yay!
Ito Maki Maki, Ito Maki Maki, hite hite ton ton ton. Ito Maki Maki, Ito Maki Maki, hite hite ton ton ton.
So while we sing the song, we can make all kinds of things for animals of very different sizes. What did we make first?
Underwear for a big brown bear.
Spool of thread, hite hite dun dun dun. Spool of thread, hite hite dun dun dun. Stitching, pulling from that spool. Underwear for a big brown bear.
Okay, we made underwear for the bear. Now we have huge spool. Who should we make something for?
A giraffe.
Sperm whale.
A gorilla.
Whoa. A whale shark.
What's
it's
that?
It's basically a 12 meter long shark, which is the biggest one in the species.
A dinosaur.
Stegosaurus.
A rhino.
A hippo. Yeah.
A panda. A grizzly.
An elephant.
An elephant. Elephant.
Yeah!
Okay, now we have a teeny spool of thread. Who should we make something for?
An ant.
Lobster.
A termite.
Crayfish.
Ooh.
A mouse.
A tardigrade.
What's that?
A tardigrade is a microscopic animal, and sometimes it floats away and it can survive on another planet.
Another planet?
Very penguin.
A pygmy marmoset.
A t-shirt for a bumblebee.
A bumblebee.
Yay! Yeah.
Ito maki maki ito maki maki hite hite tom tom tom. Maki ito maki maki hite hite ton ton ton. Dekita dekita mitsubachi no t-shirtu.
A tiny tee for a bumblebee. Our last spool of thread is medium sized. Any ideas?
Platypus.
A honey badger.
Tasmanian double.
A giant anteater.
What?
Bilby.
What's a bilby?
You know how a kangaroo has a pouch that faces up?
Yeah.
Well, a bilby's pouch faces the opposite way.
A beagle, a seagull, a slow loris.
Oh. Fluffy socks for a gray fox.
Ito maki maki, ito maki maki, hite hite, ton ton ton. Ito maki maki, ito maki maki, hite hite, ton ton ton. Dekita, dekita, kitsune no fuwa fuwa kutsushita.
Stitch and pull and out of wool. Fluffy socks for the feet of a fox.
All right, thank you to Akiko for teaching us the dance for Ito maki. I hope that you all danced along and came up with some really wild combinations of animals and clothes that you could sew together. So we're gonna go next to a song called Let It Come, Let It Go, which features a lot of my friends that I've been playing music with over the years. And the chorus of the song is just, let it come, let it go, let it drift in the river and flow, let it come, let it go. Sometimes we say, and the chorus begins to grow. Sometimes we say, until the evening begins to glow. And every other line of the verse is let it come, let it go. So you can sing along that easily. So if somebody sings a line, da, ba, ba, da, 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 ba, ba, we could all sing, let it come, let it go. Can we try that together? Let it come, let it go. All right, that's all there is to it. So I hope you enjoy this version of Let It Come, Let It Go, which features my friend Sonia De Los Santos, Claudia Zanes, Dan Zanes, John Foti, Colin Brooks, Alex Asher, and Nathan Cosey. Here's Let It Come, Let It Go.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for joining me this afternoon on this journey around the world through song and story. I'd love to end today by singing a song called Unhurried Journey. It's a song I wrote in the past year thinking about the philosophy of slowing down and taking some time to appreciate the things around us, the nature that surrounds us, the people that we're around, and to take a deep breath for ourselves. And I just want to say that I appreciate all of you for joining me today. I appreciate the Alvin Sherman Library for asking me to be a part of the series. And I appreciate all of my friends who came and played some music with me today, which is one of my favorite things to do. And I want to invite two very special friends to join me on this song, Sonia De Los Santos and Brett Parnell. And I hope that you all go forth and sing songs with the people you love. So the chorus to Unhurried Journey just says this: we're on an unhurried journey, an unhurried journey in the breeze. Come on this unhurried journey with me. Let's sing it together, shall we? Thank you again so much for joining us. Hope you enjoy. So much. See you next time. Bye.